on the farm there was a dog, some sheep, a cow, and a donkey. The donkey lived on his own in a little field and was happy enough chewing grass and singing songs. The trouble was, none of the other animals liked the singing really much.
"Stop! Stop that noise!" said the dog.
"That's not music," said the cow.
"It's a bad, bad sound," said the sheep all around.
"But it's a beautiful song," said the donkey. "It's called Donkey, Donkey, Shake Your Ears." And he began to sing again, but this time all the animals went running for cover.
"That's a terrible noise," they said.
The donkey sat down in the middle of the field. He just couldn't understand it.
"Don't worry," said a little voice just behind him.
The donkey looked around, and there on a post sat a little mouse.
"I suppose you're going to say I've got a terrible voice too," said the donkey miserably.
"No," said the mouse. "It all depends who is listening to you."
"What do you mean?" said the donkey.
"Well, different ears hear different things," said the mouse. "Take me, for instance. You wouldn't think I had a very good voice, would you? Listen."
"Psst. Oh, stop, stop," said the donkey.
"Exactly," said the mouse. "But to a mouse's ears, that's a sound as soft as butter."
The donkey looked at the mouse's ears. They were small and pink. And then he remembered that the dog's ears were long and floppy, and the sheep's ears were round and furry, and the cow's ears were different from the horse's ears, and his ears were different than all of them. "Find the ears that go with the voice," said the mouse, "and you'll always make a beautiful sound. Want to hear another mousy song?"
"No thanks," said the donkey, "if it's all the same to you." And with that, the little mouse scurried away.
"Find the ears that go with the voice," said the donkey to himself. And just then, something wonderful happened. Over the little hedge at the bottom of the hill, he saw two long gray ears. The ears were moving along on the other side of the hedge in time with his own footsteps. And it was only when he got to a gap in the hedge that he saw who the ears belonged to. It was another donkey.
"Hello," said the other donkey shyly.
"My name is Donkey."
The donkey was amazed. "I live up there on the hill," said the donkey.
"I know," said Donkey. "I hear you singing every morning, and I love it."
"You do?" said the donkey.
"Yes, it's music to my ears," said Donkey.
"And what lovely ears you have," said the donkey. "They are the finest ears I have ever seen."
"Why, thank you," said Dolly.
And the two little donkeys sat and chatted happily together as the sun went down over the farm. And of course, in no time at all, the donkey was singing Dolly his favorite song.
"Donkey, donkey, shake your ears, sing your song and sing it clear. Sweetest sound you'll ever